Six, get ready to pay more for school teacher retirements because their pension fund has a huge shortfall. Today, the Speaker of the Assembly announced his plan to tackle that problem. KCRA3's Mike Lurie shows us how this big problem will affect all of us.
Well, Golston, big is right because the gap is billions of dollars, although the actual figure is in dispute, as you are about to see. Yet everyone agrees the teachers, school districts, and ultimately taxpayers will soon be paying more.
Is it a prefix or a suffix?
Maggie Ellis has been a classroom teacher for 20 years, but the Elk Grove educator is worried now because California's teacher retirement fund is in the red.
It is my only retirement. When I do retire, I will not have Social Security, even though I paid into it for many years.
Teachers cannot collect Social Security when they retire, and their pension fund is running out of money.
CalSTRS has a shortfall in funding of approximately $71 billion and will run out of funding for the program by 2046.
That means teachers just starting in the classroom today will have no pensions at all when they retire unless something is done.
The assembly is prepared.
Assembly Speaker John Perez announced today he's launching capital hearings in February to tackle the problem.
The fix must begin this year, that there has to be shared responsibility between the state, between individual school districts, and individual teachers.
Teachers already pay 8% of their salaries towards their pension, but soon they'll be asked to contribute more to the state teacher retirement system, along with school districts and taxpayers. Critics contend Assembly Democrats are deliberately lowballing the liability figure.
So I think it's more like $80 billion. It actually comes up to $200,000 per teacher is what our liability is.
The California Teacher Association is one of the most powerful unions in the state, but even they concede asking teachers to pay more is a tough fight.
It's going to hurt. It's going to hurt for everyone. We're not under the assumption that this is going to be an easy discussion.
And it's not easy because there's a big dispute over the numbers. Assembly Democrats say the unfunded liability, as you heard, is $71 billion, but Governor Brown insists it's more than $80 billion when you count stock market losses that have already occurred. So this little $9 billion differential
there. Pretty big gap there.
Yeah, how do we get into this situation in the first place?
Well, two reasons, really. First and foremost, we're talking about retirement benefits were increased in the late 90s, but then the stock market crashed 5 years ago, and we are still trying to recover today.
Wow, okay, when you lay the numbers out, it really does open your eyes. All right, thanks, Mike. Well,